you want to sum or count or average only the visible cells, so cells where, for example, if you choose that, you only want to add that up, you can use the aggregate function. So normally we use the function wizard, but in this case it's better just to type it. So I'm going to type equals aggregate. When I open the bracket, you'll see up here it then says what you want to do. So you can see all the options. I'm going to use sum, so I'm just going to double click it. When I click comma, you'll see there's a whole bunch of options, and this is the important part. So we're going to say, you'll see it says here, ignore nothing, ignore hidden rows, so we'd normally use that one, ignore error values. For now, we're going to use this, ignore hidden rows and error values. I'm going to push comma, and now it just needs to know where to look. So I'm going to go and say highlight that, and in this case, no dollar signs. And I can close it and push enter. I'm just going to copy this across. So you'll see at the moment, the numbers are exactly the same. Nothing's hidden. Just notice this one has added up, whereas this normal sum didn't. And it's because there were error messages here. So that's useful to know. But watch what happens when we go and say, look at only the third years. So this is still the totals. But now this is only adding up the visible cells. I'm just going to clear it. This aggregate function is available in the more recent versions of Excel. If you don't have it, you can achieve something similar with the subtotal function. Only important thing here with subtotal is when I go, notice it's also got a drop-down list. So if you choose that sum, it sums everything, including hidden items. If I scroll down and I've got a 10 in front of it, that one there, it then only does the visible cells. So I'm going to click enter. And again, just to show, if I go back to year threes, you'll see that these are the same. Only difference is it can't ignore error messages.